We also have Battlefront, too.
Yes. Well, he cares about Battlefront.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Those are fight words right there.
I mean, it's all about Halo.
Well, whatever. We don't even need an intro. We just got on into it. We're going to just go ahead and have a battle of words here.
Looking 1v1 them.
God damn it. Hey guys, it's the Philosopher, and it's Thanksgiving 2015, and I just want to take a couple of seconds to say what I'm really thankful for, a few things at least, and a few of those things are you guys, the ones who check out my podcast and give me comments and feedback and, you know, have encouraged me to keep on going throughout this time, and I just really, really wanted to say thank you to you guys. I really appreciate it, and I want to keep on getting better for you guys and making new content, so look forward to more and better content in the future. I'm going to keep on going. 2016's right around the corner, so I've got to get a good, strong start on that. But I digress. Today was kind of a really laid-back podcast. We had a few new faces. They're actual members of the Console Explosion as well, but I haven't talked to them in person or online yet. So we sat down and talked about all the new games that came out, new games that we got, you know, over October, November. So many games that dropped recently. You have Halo, Call of Duty, Assassin's Creed, Star Wars Battlefront. Just a whole bunch of games coming out. And we even kind of delved into some things about movie games as well. Movies that are made from games. Film adaptations of movies. Film adaptations of games. And so we just kind of had some fun, talked a little bit, and getting ready for Star Wars movie to come out in a few weeks as well. But as always, I'm the Philosopher. You can check out all this stuff on theconsoleexplosion.com, and I really appreciate you guys for listening, and I hope you enjoy the show. Anyways, hey guys, I'm the Philosopher, and I've got a whole bunch of people, some new faces, some old. We're talking about all the gaming stuff that has happened in the last month, 2 months or so, all the new releases that have come out and announcements that they have, and just all the games, what we got, what we think about it, what we're going to get if we haven't already got it, just a whole bunch of cool stuff. So, hey guys, welcome to the show, all the new faces. We have Indy. How's it going?
What's up?
And then we also have Flip.
Hello.
And then the familiar faces, we have Tyler and Ian.
Hello.
Hi.
How's it going?
Meow.
So the first game that I want to talk about is Battlefront. That just came out last Monday. I think it's a great game. I'm really enjoying it. It's more fun with people, but has anyone else picked up the game yet? And if so, what consoles?
I picked it up for Origin.
Oh, wait, it's Battlefront.
Origin?
I'm sorry, I don't have the newest console, okay?
I just realized, you see Battlefront, right?
Yes.
I was thinking of Battlefield. Never mind, that doesn't suck.
Oh, okay.
Never mind, I'm sorry. I apologize to all the nerdies. No, I'm waiting for the price to go down.
So Tavian, did you buy the game and the $50 DLC or just the game?
Just the game. It came with some free DLC. I cannot pronounce what it's called. The Battle of Jakku. But
Yavin?
Jakku? Jakku?
Or like the Battle of Yavin or whatever?
It probably came with some free DLC, like the Slave Princess outfit or something.
No, it came with an extra gun, Ion Grenade, Ion Torpedo, Ion Shock Keymote.
You got the deluxe, though, didn't you?
Look at day one. Yeah,
it came with the console. Also, I love the controller right here.
Oh, aren't you fancy?
It came with it. I like it. I like the fiber.
I just picked up the regular one on Origin.
Yeah. I mean, it's a fun game. I definitely recommend playing it with people, though, because I couldn't figure out you can do chat, like voice chat. I'm used to old school Halo where everyone in the game just has the chat open, but I guess times have changed. I don't play a lot of shooters anymore. So have you had a chance to play it yet?
I played the crap out of the weekend beta when I did it. It was a pretty fun game. I don't really want to spend $110 on it right now.
$110? Oh, the DLC?
For the DLC and the game.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm waiting on the DLC for a while, so.
Yeah.
I won't be picking that up anytime
soon. I'm waiting to get a PS4, because I want to try it on the PC.
I played it the last couple of nights with a couple of friends, so yeah, we were having fun with that.
Nice. I want to try out that survival mode. There's like some sort of co-op. It's either split screen. I like that they have split screen and or online co-op, which is pretty cool.
Yeah, that'd probably be fun for the Heroes vs. Villains mode. You can use the hero units and fight each other. That'd be kind of fun on the same TV.
Me and my friend were doing a Hero vs. Villain mode last night. That was crazy.
Were you Vader or Palpatine?
I was Han Solo. Come on.
You don't get to pick who you get to be. It's just random. You be like,
no, you can pick. You're Palpatine. You pick.
No, I think
it was the Emperor versus Han Solo.
You can, like, on certain maps. I think you can, like, you could pick Luke, Leia, or Han, or then you could pick Vader, Boba Fett, or the Emperor.
Why? Were you playing online or offline?
Do what?
Georgia.
No, Jar Jar.
Oh, no Jar Jar. Why not?
But were you playing offline or online, Indy?
No, I was playing online with my buddy. You were able to choose who you wanted to pick.
The way it works for me is like it kind of just alternates. There's six people, like it's six on six, and like it rotates.
We were just doing the 1v1. We didn't have a. I haven't done the 6v6 set yet.
Okay. That's where it's random. It's like three people are just like troopers. And then the other three are heroes, and then every round it switches between who's a hero and who's a trooper, just to kind of make it fun, I guess, and fair.
Yeah. Okay. I actually like that. Although I think it's random, because I've gotten, like, the same person three times, but I'll get Han three times, and then Luke, like, once, and then I won't get Leia, and then vice versa.
Okay. So,
I mean, it kind of keeps it very fresh, and I like that about it. That's probably one of my favorite modes, and then... The I don't know what it's called, but the one where you play in the airplanes or the X wings and the A wings. What was that?
I never play a game, but I assume it's kind of like a dogfight, right?
Yeah. It's something like that. Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. So, and apparently.
Go ahead. I was gonna say, I don't know why they just, instead of having it down there like on the planet, I don't know why they couldn't made it look, have it being in, you know, space. The space. Yeah, mm-hmm. I don't understand why they didn't do that, because it would have been a lot more, I think.
I think it's going to be DLC. That's my bet.
That's what I'm thinking too, but I don't know.
DLC maps.
So, question for you, because I only played the beta in the Walker mode. So when you're actually doing like the mission specific for like the dogfighting, are the vehicle maneuvers still only limited by the different skill trees on the side? Or can you actually just like fly it the way you want to?
When you're playing in the Walker mode?
Well, yeah, in Walker mode, when you pick up a vehicle like a TIE Fighter or an X-Wing or A-Wing or whatever, you'd have maneuvers you could do, like a barrel roll, things like that.
And yeah.
So you could do basic maneuvers with your mouse or controller, but in order to do like the really more aggressive ones, you had to use the activated TAS on the side. Is that how it is in the dogfight mode, or is it still limited to those?
I think it's still limited, isn't it?
That's kind of important, isn't it?
No, what do you mean exactly?
Well, when I was flying, like, I was flying the TIE Fighter, and it had, like, a barrel roll function, and you had to activate the skill, basically, using your D-pad on the side.
Oh, okay.
And that would let your craft do a barrel roll, as opposed to just letting you do a barrel roll. So the controls felt really stiff, at least. I don't know, that was my experience with it.
There's left and right barrel roll, and then there's like a, I don't know what you call it, but like a U-turn essentially in the sky.
Yeah.
Those are mapped to hotkeys that have a cooldown. And I think the reason they did that was because, the only reason you use it is to avoid, like, you can break your lock on. So that's the only time you use it. You can still fly in every direction and whatnot and do a lot of, evasive maneuvers depending on what ship you have. You can, No, all of them can decelerate and accelerate, so you can control your throttle, essentially. So there's a lot of aggressive maneuvers you can do with that, but the barrel and like the U-turn move, I don't know what it's called, you have to have those mapped to the hotkeys.
Yeah, it was actually made popular in World War I.
What's that?
But the barrel, like the maneuver where you go back, I think it was a French flying ace who came up with it.
Hey.
I don't know, I guess when I was playing it, I guess the flight model felt really stiff. Didn't feel very much. I don't know, it was me, though.
It feels a lot better.
Battlefield 42. But that's it, man.
I'd like to know what your thoughts are about it, like, now that it's out, to see, because it took me some getting used to, but I like it. I'm trying to figure out if I want to play cockpit mode rather than third person. Because I play third person, like, on the infantry, but I think I prefer cockpit mode when I'm in an airplane.
You know, honestly, I'd almost recommend doing, like, a third person on the aircraft, because it opens up your field of view.
That's why I keep it that way.
You can see the planes coming in at you more.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have to check it out.
I switch between both.
Yeah. It's really easy. You can press it down on the D-pad, and it'll switch. Okay. So it's really easy to do.
That was always really fun in Rogue Squadron on the Nintendo 64. Being in the cockpit view for that, you're like, yes! That was like over 10 years ago at this point.
Oh, yeah. That's old. Oh, man, make me feel old. Thanks. Thank you.
Here's a question. Can you play the game in first person besides in the cockpit?
Yeah. You can.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can do third or first person.
Okay, that's when I'm just a soldier, right?
Yeah.
Oh, that's interesting.
Mm-hmm. I think if you're playing I think if you're playing Skywalker, it has to be in third person, like Skywalker and Vader. I'm not sure.
Yeah,
the heroes and the villains all have to be, I think, third person, but other than that.
Okay, but you mentioned you can play as Han Solo then, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay, and you can play him in first person.
I don't know. I have to try it out.
Okay.
Probably not.
I don't think you can.
It makes sense. He has a gun.
But the way they have it set up, though, is you have a crosshair and all in third person to fire a gun. So
I think they made third person because they're like from what I saw is that they do rolls and shit like that. So it would almost like make you want to throw up if you're in first person.
Well, they can do what they did in Quake 3. You don't have the whole thing turning.
Yeah,
mad.
Believe I know Quake 3, so I love that game, but. They could have done it that way.
Yeah, I'm not sure why they chose to do it. I played third person, so it doesn't bother me any. I can't really play third person anymore.
I mean, the previous game was in third person, but.
Mm-hmm.
It kind of was kind of like third person in like DayZ, gave you a really good field of view.
Mm-hmm. It's the same thing in this game, and you can switch your shoulder view. So I really enjoy that.
Which is nice.
Yeah, I hate third-person shooters that don't let you do that. I guess you're very limited to what side you can take cover on, effectively.
Oh, yeah.
Like Kane and Lynch, that was like the most painful game ever to play.
I actually heard of that game.
I never got to play that. So.
You should play Kane and Lynch 2. And the whole gimmick behind Kane and Lynch 2 is like there's a guy with the camcorder following you, so it's in third person.
The game is
what it's shaky cam. So like you want to vomit. Luckily you could turn it off, thankfully. But oh my god, it's such a piece of trash game.
Like, I played the demo and I don't think you could turn it off in the demo. And
it was trash. Like my favorite part ever was like it pretty much was like a stormtrooper simulator where like your target reticle was just a suggestion box for where bullets might go.
Oh jeez.
There's a chance it'll hit here, but
the bullet might hit over here or the bullet
just
over here.
Just upper left, you'll be good.
Okay.
But yeah, so I assume you guys are actually a bit more accurate with your laser blasters this round because the Beta was
note
hysterical.
To self,
you down how much
you couldn't
don't
hit each
pick
other
up Kane
great.
And Lynch.
Yeah, don't waste your time.
It's like $2.
But I might like the game though.
Of course you're going to.
Because there's a lot of games out there that people say it's bad, I end up liking.
All right, what's an example?
Cheetahmen. I like Cheetahmen on Nintendo.
Are you sure you don't like it just because it's really expensive? And
you have
to justify it to yourself?
No, I think it's a good, challenging game. Now, Cheetahmen 2, I understand, but in Cheetahmen 2, I do like the first two levels.
It wasn't even a finished game.
But if you got the reproduction, it's finished.
Was there one level missing out of all of that, though?
Two levels.
Yeah, see, so it's not a finished game, then.
Yeah, but if you activate the glitch, you can play those last two levels. But that's not the thing. If you get the reproduction copy, they have it fixed, so you can play the last two levels.
So I'm gonna pull you guys back, Tyler. You said you got a Tomb Raider earlier.
Yes, I played a little bit of it.
What do you think of it so far?
I like it, but man, the death scenes is brutal. I mean, I haven't seen like any like, oh, she gets her throat split or anything like that. But like when she fell, no, I haven't got to that part. But when she fell down, I heard the bones crunching.
Oh. Yeah, I used to love that about playing Tomb Raider on the Saturn, and like you'd miss that jump, and then you just crater at the bottom of the like whatever you were climbing, and you're like, ooh.
You know what I loved doing back on the PlayStation days? When I was 9 years old, I would do the training level, you know, in her house. Mm-hmm. I would go on the second
Tomb Raider 2?
No, mm-hmm. The first one.
Did the first one have a training level? Yeah, it did.
And I would be on the second story, the second story. I would jump off and dive into the ground and die on purpose. For no apparent reason. See,
you, sir, are a cruel, cruel man.
Now, his thing, Tomb Raider 2, I believe you train outside. But Tomb Raider 1, you train inside her house.
So is that the one where the butler would keep following you around?
That's Tomb Raider 2.
That's 2. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I did the same thing. I didn't do it on purpose, but I knew like, if you did the swan dive, you would like do a roll. So I think I did that, and then just like she just snaps her shit all up when she lands. It was, oh my god. I was like, I was a little kid seeing that. I was like, oh my god, it's terrible.
Remember the naked nude code in Tomb Raider 2?
I don't.
Okay, here's the thing. They put a joke. They put a joke in one of the gaming magazines saying, "Hey, you want to see Lara Croft naked? Put in this code, and you'll get to see her in the nude." But once fans put this code in, she actually explodes.
Oh yeah, I think I remember.
Oh jeez.
Wow. I remember there being a lot of fake troll ones out there. Like you had to go to a certain ledge in a certain level. And, like, do a particular maneuver. Yeah.
Yes.
I remember finding those on, like, IGN.com back in the day.
Doing a handstand or something like that?
Yeah, do a handstand on this cliff and then, like, roll forward. And it was crap like that.
Oh, find all the secrets in the game or something.
Up,
like
up,
that.
Down, down, left, up,
yeah,
up,
I found it was much easier because I had a PC just to hack the game files with skins people had made.
It's not all that impressive.
Back then, it was, like, freaking... like little triangles. You're like, yeah.
Yeah, but did you read up?
Boobs are boobs.
Yeah. Did you read up why they made her boobs big?
Oh.
It was a programming error. Yeah. But before he fixed it, his boss pretty much said no, just leave it. Just leave it.
Programming error, my ass. He was the one that put it there. He knows it. I know it. I won't say anything.
Well, that's the story anyway.
I really wish Tomb Raider wasn't a time exclusive because that was another one I wanted to pick up, but now I'm kind of glad I didn't because I've already bought Fallout and Star Wars. So
did you play?
Well,
Fallout
you got the Pip-Boy, didn't you, Indy? You got the Pip-Boy
edition. Did I get the Pip-Boy?
Uh-oh.
Did you?
Uh-oh.
Did I get the Pip-Boy?
I don't know. I see a great fucking square in your screen.
Hold on. Wait a minute. All right. Hold on.
Okay.
Did I get the Pip-Boy?
Bust it out.
How much does it weigh?
It's actually quite light. It's like only maybe a pound.
No.
You know what's weird? You know how I talk trash about I wasn't going to get Fallout 4 and everything?
The nice steel.
Why did you get Fallout 4, Tyler?
Oh, because somebody was modding My Little Ponies in it. That's why.
So you got it for... what did you get it for? PC?
PC, yes.
I got it for PS4.
I'm a PC player. I don't really have any consoles, but yes.
Well,
I just got a console, so I
there's the beauty.
Does it actually work well with the game?
Yeah, the app actually does work well. I don't know if I can get it to work or not right now, but let me see.
But
I actually had my phone in the Pip-Boy, but my phone got stuck. I'm like, I don't think we're going to put it back in there again.
I got a question. What phone do you have? What phone do you have?
Galaxy S5.
Okay, then I shouldn't do it either, then.
What's upside down?
Apparently my...
just drop your phone, no?
So, anyway, now this Fallout 4, when are they going to allow modding onto the, like, home systems?
Well, people are making mods now, actually. Or if you're talking about the console, I think they're going to be releasing all of it at once early next year.
Then, oh, so I gotta wait a couple of months to get My Little Pony on my PS4? This sucks.
I'm sorry.
You should get for PC. You can have it right now.
You could have got it right now.
With a launcher, I keep telling
everyone, I am not a PC guy. When I look at my PC, I see a bunch of tools for me to make videos and draw pictures. That's all I see it as. I didn't start gaming on PC until I joined this group.
That's crazy.
Well, I was going to show you the Pip-Boy app, but apparently my phone decided to uninstall it. But if you type in Fallout Pip-Boy on Google Android, or for your Android or for your iPhone, you should be able to find it. And there is a demo version that lets you kind of mess around. But basically, it'll show everything that you have in your inventory that's in your game, pretty much.
Did you get the special edition of 3 as well?
You got the nuke, right?
You mean? Hold on, let me see. you mean the?
I can see it from I saw it from the corner.
Click.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, I bought the nuke too.
But so how do you like Fallout 4?
Oh, I'm loving it. It's really good. I can. There's a few things I could nitpick here and there, but
like other what?
I think the facial movements are a little wonky at times. I mean, compared to some games that, you know, have really good, you know, mouth movements that you sync pretty well. Sometimes in game, I notice they're kind of jaggedy and stuff. It doesn't line up. And then, like a couple other ones, it hasn't happened to me, but a couple of friends of mine, they've actually fell through the map before.
Oh, that happens.
I've seen videos, actually.
That happens with just the Bethesda.
But it's also new.
Just how open world it is.
It's just, you know, it's so open world. I don't think Bethesda found all of the bugs yet. So.
Well, it's actually perfectly natural for Bethesda not finding all the bugs because it's such a big game.
Yeah, hard.
I mean, the first one, technically it's not Fallout, but the first Bethesda game I actually played was Morrowind for the Xbox. That had tons of glitches.
I love going into certain buildings and there's stuff floating above the table that's supposed to be sitting on the table.
Oh, so they still have that issue with Fallout 4?
Yeah.
Has it ever just, like, flew all over the place?
Now, hold up. Are you a good person or a bad person? Because I'm playing through Fallout 3 right now, and honestly, it's best to be a bad person because you can just steal everything, not give a fuck about who you kill or anything, and just have fun. I blew up Megaton without a second thought.
I can't remember what I did in Fallout 3.
And I got a nice house for it, and I'm happy. Or else I'd be living in a shack, and I can just steal whatever I want.
The nice thing, though, with Fallout 4 is you can build your own settlement, which is pretty cool.
Yes, I was going to ask about that.
Yes. Yeah, how does that work?
There's these different, like, settlements that you can find throughout the game. Right now, I'm kind of just sticking with the one that you first start out with. But you basically can make people, like, people will come to your settlement once you have it fixed up and all. You have to have clean water, you have to have food available, you have to have security, and you can assign people different jobs and everything.
Like the Fallout Shelter game, right?
It's pretty much like Fallout Shelter.
Fallout, yeah.
Wait, what's Fallout Shelter?
It's a phone game that you can get.
Basically play as an overseer for your vault, and you have to assign the dwellers different jobs and stuff.
Sounds like a DLC game, no physical copies whatsoever.
It's free.
It's free.
I don't care. I want a physical copy of every game I own.
You can't really do that with a phone game.
I'm sure they can find a way. What if we just print out a code and we just scan the code and
that would be a waste of paper.
That'd be like the dumbest thing. Go to the Play Store. You want this game? Find a printer. Print out this QWERTY code. Scan the code, then you get the game. Don't just click download.
You can do some really neat things with the settlement. Like you can build a tower, you can build a huge house, you can do whatever you want. It's interesting. I really haven't taken time yet to build a full house yet, but I kind of like a little shack together.
Yeah, you can actually you can rip apart houses and stuff like that and take all the wood from them, so you can like rip things apart, like cars for scrap. Yeah.
Yeah, but it's only in the certain settlement areas that you can take that stuff. You can't do it throughout the whole game. That's the only bummer. But yeah, you can literally tear certain houses down completely, get all the scrap, take cars, get it from metal and all, and then use that to build up your settlement.
It's kind of funny, though, like, when you build the towers, there's no, like, weight physics model to it, so you can pretty much build things suspended in midair if you want.
Can you make a penis? Like, a giant penis?
Oh, yeah. People have done that.
Yeah.
You can actually build signs that say things.
Yeah, I was going to say, you can build up light signs and everything. They showed in the trailer and stuff.
You're down. You're such a giant
kid. God dang it, I knew you were going to go there. Get out of here. God dang it.
I totally missed. What?
Jared and Kip is still the inside joke the two of them have, but no, it doesn't make sense to me.
No, Jared started it. Dang him.
Anyways, go on.
Over all of our heads, I see how it is.
Yeah, it's a long, long story.
Okay, we'll save it for another time then. Yeah. We'll have a full podcast explaining the whole entire thing.
Next podcast.
I'm trying to think. Did anybody else give me any other games that have come out recently, like Assassin's Creed?
I did get Assassin's Creed, but again, I haven't played it because I'm still playing Metal Gear Solid. But I did get Shovel Knight on the PS4. And you probably saw my little rant on Facebook about how there's no physical copies for the Xbox One. And the whole reason I wanted the Xbox One because it has Battletoads. What's the last time we got a Battletoads game? Since what, Genesis?
Killer Instinct.
Yes.
Wait, Battletoads and Killer Instinct?
Rash.
Well, I would play Killer Instinct if it wasn't for the fact that I don't get if I got my health back in the next round.
No,
exactly. You will never see me play those type of games.
God, you're so particular.
Ultra.
I'm kind of glad I didn't pick up. My wallet's hurting enough as it is. I don't need anything else. Besides, supposedly I heard rumor that the Steam sales for PC are coming next Thursday.
I'm Canadian, so I don't. I still try to figure out when your Black Fridays are. It's like a week. It's a week during Thanksgiving, right?
Yeah, it's the day we all gather and we fight for prices.
Pretty much.
After the day of being thankful for what you had, right?
Pretty much, yeah.
And then you go to malls and travel over people just to have like $50 off a blender. I love America.
It starts at 5 now on Thanksgiving.
Oh, yeah.
Some stores are actually cracking down about being open on Thanksgiving now.
They're refusing, which is actually pretty cool, in my opinion.
Which is what they should be doing, and just deal with it on Friday.
The last thing that I did get was, I haven't played it yet, because I haven't beaten the other ones, but Life is Strange, Episode 5, I think it's called Polarized. That one just dropped last month, I want to say in October. I've heard great things about it. I've luckily managed to stay away from anything. I've only played up to episode 2. But if you know anything, don't tell me anything or I will find you and murder you. But game is great so far.
I haven't played it. It's one of the ones I want to pick up at some point. But yeah, I haven't.
You should. Like a Telltale game? Or just like
it's like a Telltale game, but it's not. It is really good, though. It's a little more, I guess, slice of lifey, but
is
also
there a way you can summarize it without being spoilish?
I will try. Yeah, I'm not going to give any spoilers away, but basically you play as a college student in an art school. She's a photographer, and she gets some supernatural powers that I won't tell you what they do, but also there's some issues with some of the characters. Is a character that...
Does the camera see the person's thoughts? Or their deepest secrets.
No, I won't tell you even if it did, though. But
is this like Goosebumps, you know, the camera one and all that? No.
No, nothing like that. But she just happens to be a photographer. That kind of plays into, like, extra stuff. But it's mainly about her power and then some of the other issues with other characters going on. And it's, like, it's really interesting because you get to see, like, college life. Like, it's very accurate to some of the issues and personalities that people have during college life, and you have these morally ambiguous issues where, you know, you kind of come in and you can choose to do this or do that, and it also So you have just regular college life, which can be very dramatic on its own, but then you take in some issues that are going in with some of the people in the show or in the game. I mean, it feels very much like a show. And, you know, you have your supernatural abilities that take into account, and just all this craziness that's going on is like some weird supernatural event that's also happening at the same time, and you're trying to figure out all this thing and piece it together while also being a teenage girl or late teen girl in college. It's very, yeah, around that age.
Is that like the same game you were playing? You don't know. Is that the same game you were playing on your Let's Plays on YouTube?
Yeah, I have episode 1 and 2.
So that is the same game. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Really good. I love games that have a lot of moral choices, like the moral ambiguity. I can't even say that word. Like things that say that, you know, it's not always black and white, and that game is very much like that, which is why I love it. Like, you get to see two sides of the story. Like, this guy you think is a jackass might not be as much of a jackass as you think he is once you get to hear his side of the story. It's just really, really cool. So I definitely recommend it if you like games like the Telltale games, you know, Walking Dead, anything like that. Even Heavy Rain.
It was like that game. What's that game I have? But I actually hated it.
You say Heavy Rain, I'm gonna
Beyond Two Souls.
I only say in the sense of like making choices. Yes, William Dafoe.
So I love that game.
Jason!
Press X to Jason.
Jason!
I love that. You keep yelling it all the way till you rescue him. You come out of the water, yelling in his face.
Jason! There's another game that did that. The Park. The Park did that too.
Played that too. I played The Park too. That was really good.
Yeah. That review should be up too, side note. But that game is also... I guess it's in early access right now, but I enjoyed it.
No. It's complete.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, like, I actually really enjoyed that game.
It's an hour and a half long, but it's like a atmospheric game where like you have to pay attention to everything, and the atmosphere is like what will get you. From what I learned from that game is that it's kind of like this area that you're in is also part of the game, the Secret World.
Yeah, which is an MMO that I actually play. Yeah.
And one of the characters in that game is from that, so I was kind of confused, but then once I learned more about it, it kind of all made sense. But
I have the Secret World, but yet I have not played it yet.
I want to try it, actually.
It's really fun. I have to re-download it, but it's a really... I think it's a very underappreciated and undermarketed MMO. It has a very, very great lore. If you love anything like Cthulhu or any sort of mythical creatures or anything along that nature, secret organizations, Illuminati, the Dragon Clan, Templar, stuff like that, it's just really enticing.
Now, that's the one time, like, you pay once and that's it. You don't pay a monthly fee for that MMO, do you?
Correct.
Well, when it first came out, it was subscription-based.
But... That's what I thought, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, you can do, like, microtransactions, I think, but it's not necessary. The game still... I played it during subscription and after it went free to purchase to play. It still feels very much the same. It doesn't feel like they, like, did something like... what was it? The superhero game where it kind of just felt like you had to pay to do anything really cool. It was still very much the same game. There's Champions Online, and then there's also another one.
It was DC Universe.
DC Universe. And there's another one that came out before both of those, too, I think. But that one,
I haven't played that one yet.
Yeah. But the last big... Well, I think the last big game for us, like, I don't know if anyone's gotten Halo 5.
I did, but I haven't played it yet.
Okay, right.
Play games?
This is actually a two-parter, kind of. The big announcement is that Nintendo announced their the new character for Super Smash Bros. 4, and it turned out to be Cloud from Final Fantasy VII.
Yay!
Woo! Where's Tifa?
I'll kill you.
I doubt she's gonna be in it.
At least give me Aeris. Give me the second hottest.
She'll die instantly. Her special is she gets stabbed through the chest and she dies.
So, but remember, Super Smash Bros. Pretty much a bunch of toys getting together and fight. That's basically what it is.
special, everyone would stab her.
I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm just throwing that out there. So.
But it's kind of a big deal, though, because, one, I'd like to know how they got the rights to the character.
Yeah, because the Square Enix, right? Yeah.
Well, not so much that, because Nintendo, Square started on Nintendo when they were Squaresoft and whatnot.
With the PlayStation. I love Chrono Trigger.
Final Fantasy VII was a Sony exclusive game, and I don't know if that's an indicator that Final Fantasy VII, the remake, is coming out for, like, they're doing something for Nintendo, or they just somehow got the rights, because, I mean, even Ryu has been on Nintendo multiple times, from Tatsunoko all the way back to, like, you know, regular Street Fighters on Super NES and NES, I think. But, yeah, I mean, this character just doesn't make any sense for a Nintendo. Like, why Cloud? I'm not complaining. I think it's
impossible. Well, was he still part of like, the fan polling, though? Was this one still part of, like, the fan polling?
I'm sure he was. But how? Like, how did this happen? You know, all the legalities between Nintendo and Sony, like, that's just very... I need to do more research on this. I don't know if any of you guys know anything about it, but it's just...
I assume they made a deal where Sony gets... like profits from the DLC purchases towards that character.
Well,
that's what I think that kind of makes sense, but
yeah. Well, think of it this way: you have Sony announcing a Final Fantasy VII HD remake.
Yep.
So how better than to draw attention to this game by reintroducing Cloud to the popular consciousness with this game?
Yeah.
Just putting him out there, drawing attention to yourselves via that way. It's just. It's free PR for their own game, so it works
true,
really well.
Because I guess the average age group for Smash is between, let's say, 10 and up.
People.
Yeah.
Definitely Smash has a lingering audience with older people, especially people who play Final Fantasy VII.
Yeah. But this is also a way to introduce, I guess, Cloud to the younger gamers, too.
Yeah, younger gamers as well. With the HD remix, it will definitely bring Final Fantasy VII front and center for
people. I play this guy in Smash. Let's see how he is. Actually, a real game.
It's
a lot different. Why are we taking turns fighting? This doesn't make sense.
I think they're changing up the battle system in the new remake, though.
They are.
But, yeah, and they're doing like a nerd. I thought he said that they're like the stories must be like a remake too. Like it's not gonna be like the same game.
I'm sure they're gonna keep the overall core of it, but they might even add some of the stuff from Crisis Core in there. I wouldn't be upset if they did. I can't think of it was like Aegis and the other guy. I can't remember their names. But that was really cool. That game was great. I liked
Crisis Core?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Have you beaten it?
Zach?
No. I still have my PSP, so I...
Okay. I would say, if you did, I'm stuck on Sephiroth. You need to help me out on that one.
If I get that far, I'll help you out. I'll give you some tips.
Okay. I'm stuck in there.
Is it terrible that I've never played Smash or Final Fantasy?
Yes.
Not really.
Final Fantasy VII is on Steam right now.
But here's the thing, if you're not into turn-based, then no.
Yeah.
So there you go.
But what about Smash, though? Everyone talks about it, and I've just...
Well, I didn't like Smash until last year.
I love Smash. I just like it because it's a good party game that you can play with your friends, but sometimes you might get that one friend who actually tries hard and, then he's not as fun as playing with the other friends who are just like filling around with characters. And my favorite weapon in all Smashes was the fan, because I pissed off so many people with it. It became one of those items that people had to remove when they were playing against me. But then it wasn't even in the latest one. I was really sad because I really liked the fan.
You probably wouldn't like playing with us. We actually play with no weapons on usually.
Oh yeah, I do too. But it's just like. I just love the fan because you can get them like in the loop and they just keep them there.
We had a party last week where we played the N64 version and I was like unstoppable in that. And I got the fan instead of whacking people.
Exactly. People were just like...
Man, now, the price of the N64 game has skyrocketed. How much is it going for now? Maybe 100?
You guys probably wouldn't like playing with me in board games and stuff because I'm one of those try hard people that want.
I have the best luck in video games, but the worst luck in board games. Like,
well, I'm the same with video games too. I want to win. I'm not like there's some people that I know that are worse than me at certain games like Counter-Strike, but I'm one of those try hard people. Do what?
I said, get on my level.
Get on my level, scrub. Come on.
I never plan to win. I never plan to win. I play for fun, but if I win, I'm excited, but...
I play to break people's souls is what I
don't do. Don't you lie to us, Tyler. You know you want to win.
Yeah, I do want to win, but it's
you
so...
play for fun.
I play for fun. Like, I killed Indy and one of our other friends just for fun, and it kicked me out of the game.
Oh, yeah, that was... I think I have that recorded. I need to upload that. That was hilarious.
So I got to backtrack a little bit because I had one more question for about Nintendo. Like, I want to know what you guys think about, since Cloud did get announced, you know, he's not a Nintendo character at all. Has no affiliation with Nintendo. Yeah. Right. What do you think this means for any more? Because he's not the last character to come out for
us. Oh, no.
Like,
no.
That kind of opens the floodgates of possibilities for non-Nintendo characters.
A lot of people wanted Banjo-Kazooie in that game.
Yeah.
A lot of people want Banjo-Kazooie.
I can see Crash and Bandicoot trying to get in there.
Crash, I think there was Crash, like Banjo-Kazooie, Shovel Knight. People want Shovel Knight to be in there. I think he's going because there's Amiibo off that.
They need Indy. That's who they need.
I would like to see Scorpion from Mortal Kombat in there.
That won't happen, but...
I think it's a possibility.
Maybe a superhero.
As long as not Superman.
People also wanted Geno from...
From Super Mario?
RPG. Yeah, from Super Mario RPG.
That'd be
kind of
cool.
So, there's a lot of people, like, characters that people wanted that out. King K. Rool was one of them. He was leading the polls for a while.
What I'm saying is, like, they're all Nintendo characters that you're naming off, which is, like, those are all very viable characters. Yeah. But what I'm saying is, like, do you think Nintendo's going to waste slots on more Nintendo characters, or are they going to, like, now
they might have a couple more just for, like, the third party, just for the fan service, but I think they're going to focus towards more, like, almost bringing, like, their characters in.
Mm-hmm.
Depends on, like, what deals they have with other companies, because they still like to make money.
Yeah, definitely. I mean,
they bring in third-party people, like other major companies to, you know, game developers to bring their characters to life to that?
They would have to look at the characters and figure out what moves they want, and they would have to... I don't know if the company gives Nintendo complete control of the characters, or if they have any input under what the character will look what the moves will be.
Like, for instance, like, not to mean to interrupt you, but, like, okay, like, you said the new character was Cloud, right?
Yeah.
And he's from Square Enix, is that what you said?
Yep.
Yes.
So, wouldn't there be a possibility, if they're working with Square Enix, couldn't they maybe port over Lara Croft and have different things like that? I don't know what kind of moves she would have. But
she would have guns and boobs.
She'll probably have some kind of artifact that shoots a laser beam or something.
I mean, she has a lot of different array of guns. She'd probably be a projectile character.
Bow and arrow. Explosives.
Well, I was just thinking, I mean, that'd be a kind of possibility if they would work with other gaming companies to bring their characters over to Smash. I mean, it'd be a far-fetched type of idea, but with Cloud and Square Enix, I wouldn't see why they couldn't bring Lara Croft into the mix with it, too. I mean, stuff like that.
I think they they just have to agree on
on payment or what they're paid up front, blah, blah, blah. You know,
and if they think people are going to waste money on this character, because people get buy Cloud like that. They bought Ryu like that. They bought.
Let me ask you this: Is Smash kind of like Disney Infinity? Is it Infinity? Infinity? What is it?
Infinity.
Mm-hmm. Is it like that where you have to buy the characters, or is it completely different?
Yeah, all these characters now are that we're talking about, like, DLC. So you get to spend $5 roughly per character.
I think it's like $5 or $6. So to answer your question, the way it works is when you bought Smash Brothers for Wii U. You got most of the characters, but like there's some new characters that released. Lucas, Roy, Ryu, and Mewtwo, and now Cloud are all DLC characters.
Okay, but so I mean, are these like physical things that you put like how Disney Infinity has?
You don't need the Amiibos.
Yeah, they're just DLC. Like they.
Okay.
You can't use the Amiibos to train like. Like a computer
fight. Yes. Well, I know you're talking about DLC, but I'm talking about like the original game. Is that how you had to do it, or no?
No.
Or is it all in on the disc itself, and that's it?
Yep.
Okay. You have to unlock it by doing other stuff, but yeah.
But what's the other thing from Nintendo that uses a little...
Amiibo?
Skylanders?
Yeah.
Or Skylanders?
Is that what that is?
There's Skylanders and Disney Infinity.
There's so many I don't even know. They're expensive, and I just
except,
go, no.
Except Skylanders on all three systems, same with Disney Infinity.
Yeah. Okay. You might be thinking of the Amiibos, but those aren't like the Skylander type deals. They're just like they just have multi-function, but they're not usually a part of the core game.
Okay.
Yeah.
We like on
Samus right here. Aw, yeah.
Okay, yeah, that's kind of what I'm talking about.
Zero Suit Samus.
Or my Golden Mario. Aw, yeah.
Mario sucks.
I'll cut you.
Mario is OP in that damn game.
I play as Falco.
Falco's good. Captain Falcon's good, too.
Let's see. What other games I bought recently? I bought Yoshi's
Like the Light Gun Dog.
So, for instance, with Disney Infinity, I was always wondering this, and I don't play it, and I don't think I'll ever play it, but with them bringing Star Wars over, I keep thinking, well, they have the they own Lucasfilm now. When will they bring Indy over?
Just accept the fact that they might not, and just move on with your life.
They probably... Well, no, that ends. I don't want to change topics, so never mind. There's a whole discussion I could get into with all that, but I won't get into it now.
There's always the possibility of future. Just put a thumbtack in there, memorize it, and then we can always talk about it in the future.
We can always dream.
We got a fourth Indiana Jones movie to talk about. Oh, wait, not fourth, fifth.
Really?
No, I'm joking.
There's nothing yet, or I would have known about it.
I thought you were making a joke about the fourth movie and how we're not going to talk about it. But
no, I like the fourth movie.
Wait, what fourth movie?
Exactly.
Ain't there four of them, though?
See, the sarcasm.
Okay. The
sarcasm. I think that's the last
cricket
big...
impression. Sorry, go on.
I was going to say, I think that's the last big thing that's come out. Is there anything you guys can think of that I've missed?
Shovel Knight.
You mentioned that.
So you have the... But Activision and Blizzard opening their own movie studio with a bunch of Call of Duty movies in the pipe and Warcraft movies. But that's kind of
Warcraft movies. I could see someone being entertained. I don't know about Call of Duty.
Is the Call of Duty going to be the same thing over and over again like it is now?
Minor changes. Yeah, I mean, literally, that's the perfect movie format for people.
Yeah.
Transformers, that was the same movie,
Will the movie be based on multiplayer?
Yeah,
I don't have a problem with video game companies doing movies based off their games, as long as it's done right with a good production company and a good director.
What was the last good video game movie?
Dead or Alive. That's the problem. There really hasn't been a good one. That's the thing.
We talked about
hopefully Warcraft. I'm hoping will be good.
Mortal Kombat. The first Mortal Kombat was actually okay. It was decent.
That's true. Johnny Cage fucking people in dicks. That's always good.
Final Fantasy VII Advent Children. That was amazing.
That is true. I actually will agree with that. But what were you going to say, Ian?
Okay. Yeah, so the problem you have in Hollywood is, in essence, these video game companies develop this property, and then they basically sell the licensing agreements. Yeah, they sell it. And then they lose creative control of the game. And so you end up with producers and people who have no experience or any exposure to these games.
Like you are
trying to a film. Oh, Umbel?
Yeah. Him.
Yeah, that guy was, yeah.
Yeah, he was.
He's a category all on his own of just making slack. But
who is this guy?
Umbel, he's a German movie director who bought the rights to a number of films and through basically a German tax loophole. Managed to make money back on the biggest pieces of crap ever.
Watch what? Can you give me an example?
Far Cry?
In the Name of the King, Alone in the Dark, Far Cry.
Yeah.
Blood
Rain.
Blood Rain. Yeah.
Yeah.
But there were several Blood Rain movies, I think, too.
Yeah, but the nice thing you have Ubisoft, it basically went out of their way to negotiate an unheard of agreement where they're making a movie and they maintain complete creative control over the film. So that right there will probably make the Assassin's Creed movie actually decent, not to mention you've got Michael Fassbender in it, who's going to do a pretty good job.
I'm really hoping that turns out good, though.
Yeah,
it's one of those films where if the movie doesn't do well, it'll be a failure in marketing. It won't be a failure in performance, in my opinion.
I agree with you 100%. I think this might be the first actual like blockbuster video game movie that might... This and Warcraft, I don't know too much about the Warcraft production, but we talked about this in the previous podcast and like discovered a lot about how much in-depth Ubisoft is going to be with the company. Mm-hmm. And everyone involved, it does their job very well. So I think altogether they can do a really good job, especially if they get like the historical accuracy that they get in the games, and you know, Fassbender does his usual good performance. And I can't think of the director right now for some reason. That's lost my thought.
But, well, that's like there was an interview with Gabe Newell, and they were talking. This was like several years back, and they were asking him about, well, would you ever want any of your games to be made into movies? And he says, well, we've had several companies wanting to try to do that, and then, you know, we just really said no because we don't really want it ruined. But then there was a recent, he was on the stage with J.J. Abrams, and Gabe Newell and J.J. are pretty good friends, because I think Valve did an interactive trailer for Super 8 for Portal 2. It's like a little side thing you can go to and look at it. And so they collaborated with that, and it was really good. And JJ said, yeah, I would love to do a Portal movie or a Half-Life movie. He says, I think it'd be really successful, and as long as it's done right. So,
I could see a Half-Life movie working more than a Portal, or no, sorry, a Portal movie working more than Half-Life. It could go with like Gordon Freeman not talking.
Well, no, that,
but in Portal you don't talk either. Like, no. Literally, the entire the stories are carried by the individuals around you and what
I'm
doing.
Yeah, so
that those... doesn't translate well to film just because of the way stories are told.
But see, with that kind of movie, the way that gaming universe is entitled, there's so much you can do, because you don't have to necessarily have the stories of Gordon or of Chell from Portal.
I don't think it's
because
it doesn't matter.
I don't know at the top of my head. Okay, I'm sorry. Anyway, there's so much you could do. Like, you could do a backstory on the 7-Hour War and all that, and you could have it from a different perspective of somebody. Like, there's a lot of fan films out there now that's done an incredible job, and they based it off the 7-Hour War, not necessarily Gordon Freeman. So, I mean, there's ways you could probably pull it off, and it would work pretty well, too.
Like,
now, granted, yeah, it'd be neat to see, like, a Gordon Freeman thing, but that's the other case is, you know, you kind of know what Gordon looks like, but, you know, you're technically, you're him, so you're his voice, technically, even though you don't hear him in-game. So how do you portray that in Hollywood? That's a different story.
Yeah. The Doom movie was that sequence where they do the first person.
That's cool.
They're gonna do it. I saw that movie just for that sequence.
I liked that little Easter egg that they did. That was kind of cool.
Hey, is that movie any good? Because my friend seems to really like that one.
It's meh.
Not really.
it's a meh. Like,
you can watch it once and go, eh, I won't probably watch it again.
Because the way he explains it to me seems like he really enjoyed it, and he told me I should really go see it. He's not like a hardcore gamer or anything, so...
I just really like Flip said, I liked it just for that sequence, because it's kind of a nod to the old, you know, the shooter. Yeah. So it was kind of cool seeing that.
Did any of you guys watch the Need for Speed movie?
I didn't. I saw bits and parts.
I don't care for racing cars and whatnot.
I saw it on an airplane. Because that was the guy that had Breaking Bad in it, right?
Yeah. Aaron Paul.
Aaron Paul.
I made a joke on how you would like watch the first hour, but then you have to pay extra for the ending.
Wasn't Michael Keaton in that too, I think?
I don't think so. But to kind of go full circle real quick, I was going to say that I think a good... Gordon Freeman? Yeah, Gordon Freeman would be the guy from Breaking Bad. Not him, but the other guy.
Bryan Cranston?
Yeah, I think he'd make a decent Gordon Freeman once he grew the hair back out. I think that's what I'm thinking of.
Well, there's several. It depends on like how old you want Gordon to portray. Like, some people wanted Dr. House to portray him.
Hugh Laurie?
Yeah, Hugh Laurie, sorry. They wanted either Hugh Laurie to play it, and then Bryan Cranston to be another one. There's several actors that, you know, that people's Photoshop, like, oh, yeah, this would look really cool, you know. So, I mean, it depends on what age you want Freeman to be portrayed as. That's pretty much it.
Yeah, see, the funny thing, I always thought, like, they'd adapt Halo into a film, but then that just became Halo 3.
They tried.
Well, they did a live action series, didn't they?
They did some kind of live action movie, and then they did
Until Dawn.
The live action movie sucked.
What? Well, that's kind of like, you know, changing from Halo. That's how, like, how the Uncharted, there's been talks about the Uncharted movie, mm-hmm. and how they've been just constantly talking about it, and how originally they are having the company, I think Naughty Dog wanted Mark Wahlberg to play Nathan Drake, and the fans stood up and said, "No, that is a terrible choice. Why would you have him?"
Oh yeah, Max Payne. I remember that now.
Oh yeah.
They should have Nolan North, if anybody, I think.
Well, that, but Nathan Fillion.
Yeah, I think they're gonna go with Nathan Fillion for that.
Fillion really wants to play that part. Like, he wants to, because he really enjoys that. But I don't know, with his commitment with Castle and all that, and because of his age, I don't know if he's able to do that, you know?
How old is he?
He's in his 50s, I believe.
How old is Robert Downey Jr.? Because he's pretty old, and he does, like,
oh,
he's in his 40s, I think. Maybe
if he
early 50s.
Younger, he would be the perfect Nathan Drake, for sure. I mean, he pretty much was Nathan Drake in Firefly.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Take my
I remember Final Fantasy Spirits have been now. So I'm looking at a list of video game movies.
I was expecting so much different shit from that.
Well, the best part about that, you're like, well, I was thinking Final Fantasy, the movie, when they announced it, I was thinking something like Final Fantasy VII, because that was out.
Yeah. Well,
one of the most recent games for it.
Well, but have you seen Final Fantasy VII Advent Children?
Yes, I guess.
Okay, now which version did you see? The DVD or the Blu-ray?
The one that came out.
Well, has it
the one that came out, whatever.
So, well, yes, but the DVD version has nothing but action scenes, while the Blu-ray also has action scenes, but it's more focused on story and dialogue.
Yeah, I remember you talking about that.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, do you know which one you...
Look, all we're saying is Spears Within sucked. That's all we're saying.
No, here's the thing.
CG was amazing, though.
Here's the thing.
Oh, yeah.
My little brother actually liked that movie. Now, I have it, but I haven't seen it.
Do you like Final Fantasy?
I do.
Then you probably won't like it.
No, okay, my little brother...
This is Tyler we're speaking about. So whatever you think is the exact... opposite.
Yeah, Tyler's having a special opposite day.
Every day is opposite day for him.
No, my little brother told me that if you like Final Fantasy, you won't like this because it has nothing to do with Final Fantasy. But for what it is, he thinks it's a good movie.
I can get behind. Well, I can see where you're coming from. I mean, it was a very well made. Like, I like the CG. As a person who's into like animation and game design, I like the CG. The storyline, it just, like, I fell asleep. Like, the storyline just didn't interest me.
It's boring. I couldn't remember what was going on.
Effectively, these weird alien spirits had overrun the Earth because they crashed into it in a meteor impact, and humans had fallen back into fortified cities.
Okay.
So it was like that.
When did that movie come out?
2001.
Like,
2001.
I mean, I can tell you the worst video game movie, and that was fucking Dead or Alive. I was so pissed.
Oh, God.
Dude.
Was it about boobs?
No, it was, whenever my little brother was flipping through trailers on demand on the cable box, and I was like, wait, that's just Dead or Alive right there. Click on that trailer.
Actually, I think it's
one. I was like, holy crap, that's going to be a Dead or Alive movie. And the day it came out, it wasn't into any major theaters, but it was in this $3 movie theater. I'm like, so what?
I'm
like,
DVD?
No, I saw it on a $3 movie theater. Saw it. It fucking sucked. They didn't fucking...
Well, there's your first mistake.
They fucking sucked. Yeah, it fucking sucked. They didn't follow the story at all. The actors they picked didn't really look like the characters. Except maybe Ayane, but...
So I'll have to cut you out. We ran out of time here.
Oh, I was just gonna quickly say that there was at least one board game movie done well, and that was Clue.
Clue, yeah.
I thought it was
Clue was good. Battleship,
yeah, that was great.
That was the greatest. Let me tell you.
Okay, I gotta say something about Battleship here that I absolutely love. The best part, like, they're reactivating the USS Missouri, which has been sitting in mothballs dry. In Pearl Harbor. And my favorite part ever is these Navy guys are sitting there. Then all of a sudden, these World War II veterans that served on the Missouri just come out of the woodwork to help them bring the ship back to life. that was just the best part. And then somehow they still managed to have the 1,300-pound explosive shells on the USS Missouri. And not to mention, like, in the Missouri, you have a gigantic powder magazine, which you have powder kegs that are this big that go in behind the round because it doesn't have standard casing. And somehow they have this just sitting around in Hawaii for this ship. And I'm like, what?
Because you never know. Fucking modulars are attacking.
This Missouri fight advanced aliens that, oh, God.
It's America. You're
America. No, but Clue was awesome. Clue was very well done.
The Clue did wonderful was at the end. It had all these things like, no, this is how it really happened.
It had three different endings, which was the best thing ever. And the best thing was when it released, each movie theater had a different ending.
Oh.
So that's how they did it. And then when it was released on like video and all, then they put all three endings. So that was what was cool about it.
Nice.
But yeah. That's one of my favorites right there.
That's what I remember. I actually remember the ending, but I never actually saw the whole movie. I only saw the ending. And I don't know how that happened, but I walked in the room like, oh, here's three endings.
Favorite quotes like, it was Wadsworth with a revolver in the lounge. Now, excuse me, I'm going to go home and sleep with my wife.
Didn't they have a conversation about how many bullets did he shoot or something?
2 + 1 + 1, just 2.
Yes, that's the scene I remember.
I love it. It's one of my favorite movies of all time.
Like I said, I never saw the whole movie. If it's on Netflix, I'll watch it.
I highly suggest you pick it up and watch it. It's really good.
There was Alone in the Dark 2? What?
Don't you guys get distracted. It sounds like we got some stuff to talk about for next podcast, but I'll just go down the line. You guys tell them where you can find them and you know what you guys do. First is Ian.
Yeah, I'm the Historic Nerd. You can find me at www.historicnerd.com or on theconsoleexplosion.com. And if you want to talk to me directly, feel free to send me a message at Historical Nerd on Twitter or go to my Facebook page.
All right, and where can they find you, Indy?
Well, I don't really have a YouTube page set up yet, but you can find me on Console Explosion and basically do reviews and their graphics for the site. So,
all right.
Find me there.
All right, and Flip, what about you?
I don't do much stuff either, but I think on the
Slacker?
On the videos coming up on Console Explosion, you'll probably hear me in the background yelling at people, so that's where you'll find me.
Or getting me killed.
Or getting Indy killed, which I probably won't happen a lot.
And last but not least, Tyler?
You can find me like pretty much everywhere. I'm on YouTube, the Video Game Hunter, or you can type in Hot Anime 32, I'll still pop up.
Wait, Hot Anime 32?
Yes.
Hot. Okay.
Hot Anime 32. Yeah, I was 18.
Let's just Google that, shall we? Let's just do that right now.
Okay.
Reddit, what? Death Note.
You can find me on Twitter. You can find me VGH32, Demon Art, Video Game Hunter, and Facebook, The Video Game Hunter. If you do search Hot Anime 32, you won't find a lot of disturbing pictures.
I'm actually looking at images right now. What the fuck?
Is that
man?
Super popular.
It is Universe of Cheetah, isn't it? Oh my god, it is! That's a nice picture.
Which one are you looking at?
And that's how we end that.
I'll let Tavian out for you guys.
How do I do the new button? All right, so anyways, I'm Philosopher. You can find me on Facebook.com/Philosopher, YouTube/ThePhilosopher, Twitter @ThePhilosopher, but of course always on the Console Explosion. You can always check out all these guys. They're all cool. They do crazy stuff. Some of them have some ADD, but it's okay. I forgive them. It's cool. But yeah, hit that subscribe button because we always upload new videos, all kinds of different things, podcasts. We started doing our intercast as well. We should have a new one coming up, but always check out our new one with Ralph Bakshi. And also, if you're listening to us on Mixcloud, hit that follow button so you can get all the updates. And as always, I'm the Philosopher, and I will see you in the next one.